This organization motivation segment on Bridge Street is sponsored by Kraus Hospital and Kraus Spirit of Women.
It's the one room in your house that can be the most disorganized, and the chore of tackling it becomes a chore in and of itself.
That's right. We're talking about the laundry room, and Deb Cabral joins us this morning with some ways, four simple ways to make laundry not so much a chore.
Yes, lighten the load, as we say.
There we go.
Well, first we're going to start with creating a laundry schedule. And I was telling you guys off camera, you know, we work with a lot of busy families, and we try to help them manage their time. And laundry is a big, you know, a big part of keeping the household functioning and keeping everybody dressed. So one of my favorite responses from one of our clients was, I wait till my son is out of underwear, and I either run to the store and buy him another pack, or I throw in a load. So we're like, that's not working. We need to come up with something a little bit better. So this is just something cute that you can make up, you can do it yourself, you can find these on Pinterest, just creating a laundry schedule. And so you can list, you know, what day you'd like to do each type of laundry. There's always a little reminder down there about going through the clothes, and we're going to talk about that in a minute. And so I think creating a laundry schedule is really important, because if you leave it to chance, it really can become chaotic. Mm-hmm. So, for example, another family worked with, their son played baseball. Now, you know, when you're playing baseball, you get very dirty. So they were driving themselves crazy trying to get those pants cleaned and ready for the game that was 2 days later. So something simple is just buy an extra pair. Have two pairs of the baseball pants, something really easy, as opposed to driving, you know, yourself absolutely crazy. So if you have that schedule, the most important thing is to stick with it.
Okay.
The next thing, people have problems sorting their laundry.
Yes. Well, sorting is, that's my one of my favorite things to do, and because it involves organizing. So you can use baskets like this, and what you can do is just take a Sharpie or a label maker and, you know, mark it darks, whites, towels. We like to do hand wash too. There are lots of things sometimes that we wear that are hand wash. Dry cleaning, we have a pile for that. Sheets. And then, you know, your towels. So it's important to just figure out a system that's going to work for you. Sometimes these individual baskets, some people like to color code them. This is something from like one of those companies, 31, where you can buy them, and they're really canvas. And I like it because it makes it very easy to carry.
Yes. Downstairs, do the laundry.
This is great for me because I have a bad back. This is always difficult because I'm putting it on my hip. Mm-hmm. I love these, so these work great for me. So you've got to figure out what works for your family and what type of category. Some people say, well, I don't have hand wash. Well, then you don't need it. You can do things where these can be up on a shelf. There's also systems that you can buy where you can actually install the baskets. Mm-hmm. But having an easy place to sort makes the laundry go a lot quicker, because when you come down and you've got the pile of everyone's, you know, dirty clothes, you've got to make sure that, so you don't ruin the clothes, that you're washing them on the right cycle and you're doing like kinds together. So setting up a sorting system is really important.
Okay, then when you talk about sorting,
yes,
making sure that everything's out of the pocket, this was an interesting little tip.
Yeah, this was a good one too, because, you know, we know that sometimes if you're not really carefully sorting and you're putting darks and you have that one white sock, it's going to come out and it's going to be dark, like your black jeans that may have been in there with you.
Yeah.
So the sorting is important, but also going through all the pockets. So, you know, you always go through a pocket and you find cash, sometimes
your
you
paycheck.
Find, yeah, you pay stubs, you know, maybe lottery ticket stubs, whatever it might be. I suggest keeping like a little, this is actually something that I use, it's just like a little tray, and you know, you find money, you might find important, you know, appointment cards, coupons, whatever it might be, but when you're emptying the laundry, put everything right in there, and then you can take that basket around to everyone's room, and I always say whoever does the laundry gets to keep the money.
Is that a winning lottery card?
It is a winning one.
Oh, it is. Well,
then you get to take it. You get to keep it too if you found it.
So having that little basket right there and then going back and you know, passing it back to everybody. And then the other thing I want to tell you too is, believe it or not, like if you cuff your pants, it's really not a good idea to wash them cuffed, because then you're going to get that line.
Oh,
so always uncuff all of your pants, even unbuttoned your shirts.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, people forget that, because when things are being washed in the laundry, the button can, you know, kind of form pressure during the sprint, and you can, you know, break a lot of buttons. So, you know, make sure all of your pants, you go through all of them, and the shirt you unbutton.
Next up, be thorough while loading it. You just throw things in, don't you? Isn't that?
No. You want to make sure that you don't over extend either the washer or the dryer, because I know in our house, sometimes when my younger daughter does it, you hear the noise, because it'll make like a really loud noise, my washer anyway, when it's overstuffed. When you're putting things in, kind of make sure you're putting them around too, sorting them. And balance them, very important. With the dryer, we always tell people that drying is like the second step, wash, dry, fold and put away, are the levels that maybe people sometimes forget. So when you're going to have your clothes in the dryer, if at all possible, make it so that you're home, because the best thing to do to avoid wrinkled clothes and save on ironing is to get things when they come right out of the dryer. So we have, we have a hanger, a rack with a hanger. We keep extra hangers there. We take things right out and we hang them right up. Also, the things that maybe you don't want to dry, you can take them wet right out of the washing machine, hang them on a hanger, mm-hmm. and then don't put them in the dryer. And that really extends the life of your clothes, too, to spend a little more time really paying attention to the laundry.
And don't neglect the lint
collector. Is always our reminder, because that could really form a fire hazard. So every time you're emptying your dryer, just make it part of your routine. Take out that lint, clean it out, keep a nice basket there to get rid of all of your lint and anything else that you need to throw away. And it'll make it a lot easier.
Yeah.
Having a plan always helps.
Certainly does.
Yes. And don't forget, you can find Deb on News Channel 9 every Saturday at noon with Organization Motivation, then 1:30 in the afternoon on ME TV.